The other way to get the reference of class dot class object is getClass method. The getClass method is public, final and native method of java.lang.object with signature this one. The getClass method returns reference to the type class. Since the getClass method is in java.lang.object and all the classes in Java are direct or indirect children of java.lang.object, so the method getClass gets inherited in each object in Java. The getClass method returns reference of class object of color class and reference variable of type class. GetClass is an instance member of all the classes in Java. So in this case, here we have created an object of type example, and by using the reference variable e of type example, we are calling the getClass method. The getClass method returns the reference of class.class object corresponding to the class example, and that will be stored into the reference variable c of type class. So by using the getClass method, we can only get the reference variable of type class.class object of that class whose reference variable is used to call the method getClass. But by using the class variable or forName method, we can access the reference of class.class object corresponding to any class. After getting the reference of the class.class object corresponding to the class example in the reference variable c of type class, we are printing the reference variable c, which prints the class name. Similarly, when we call the method toString on the reference variable c, it will again print the class name. Now we are creating an object of type use and storing its reference in the reference variable u of type use. By using the reference variable u, we are calling the getClass method, and whatever is returned by the getClass method will be stored into the reference variable c. The getClass method, when called by using the reference variable u, it will return the reference of corresponding class.class object, and that will be stored into the reference variable c. Here in this case, these two cases, we are printing the reference variable c, and then we are calling the method toString by using the reference variable c. It will again print the string class use. Let me try this code practically. Open example.java, and this is the same code as we have seen. Now open use.java. Again, this one is the same code as we have seen. Try to compile this code. Java C, example.java, and use.java. It compiles fine. Now run it. Java use. It returns fine and printing corresponding output. This is the JVM memory corresponding to the previous example. We have two objects of type example and use, and we have two class.class objects corresponding to the class example and corresponding to the class use. That's all for this video, guys. Don't forget to like and share this video. Subscribe my channel on YouTube, like my page on Facebook, and leave your valuable comments in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.